chair. So I'll try.
Hey guys, it's Mitch and Barney here again with another update video, but now we're here with Daniel Thielen. He was one of the boys that we stayed with in Istanbul, and now he's stuck with us up until Montreal, which is in a few weeks.
So it was awesome catching up with these guys in Istanbul. Now I'm travelling and training with them for the next few weeks, so really looking forward to that. Just thought I'd do a quick recap on the Series A in Istanbul, which was a large competition, had about 200 athletes in each division. I went through my first two rounds. First round, I beat Kazakhstan quite convincingly. I was really happy with the way I fought. The second round, I fought an Argentinian who I'd fought before at another Premier League event, so we kind of knew each other pretty well. And it was a bit of a slow fight, but I was able to fight through that. Third round, I lost to France 0-0. There was a few ups and downs from this comp. I found myself a little bit passive in the third round and now need to know what I need to work on going forward.
Yeah, it was up and down performance for me as well. I came into this comp pretty prepared. I had a great competition in Czech just before it. I had a great warm-up, and first round I beat the guy from Belgium, and wasn't too bad. Second round I won that pretty convincingly as well, and then I was up in the third round, scored a couple of points, and on 0 seconds got hit with a spin kick, which was devastating. But you know, at this level of the game, you need to be 100% focused for all 3 minutes of the fight. But as I said, it was a strong start for me, and I think if that was 1 second later, I think I would have been for sure. A great day, so yeah. A bit disappointing.
I lost to Iran in the first round. It was a close fight, but he ended up being too good, and he went up to win the division. So lucky for me, that meant that I was able to fight on Sunday for the repercharge rounds, and I felt pretty strong and confident taking wins over Belgium and Germany and Turkey. So I was actually stopped in the fourth round against the world champion from Croatia. So that put me at ninth place. And I think this one was my best Karate One performance that I've done ever.
So we shot back to Kazakhstan after Istanbul. It's a bit different here than last time for me. I was here early in the year when it was about minus 15 degrees. And now it's like 35.
That's crazy.
Different. But we're back at the Olympic Centre, and this place is really awesome. There's great facilities, and it's a very focused environment when we're around here. So we wake up, train in the morning, eat, train again, go to sleep, and then repeat it the next day. It's really cool. But there's a lot of hard training, but we also have some really good recovery sessions. So we hit the Russian sauna, and we do that with the cold pool as well. I think it's a bit of a shock for the boys hitting the Russian sauna. It's a bit different. They get it very hot. Not only that, one of the boys will jump up with the towel and start swinging it around in the sauna, and it just disperses the heat over your whole body. It's actually not enjoyable at all.
It feels like your biscuits.
It's great for the muscles the next day.
Yeah, the training here has been awesome. Like, you have the Kazakhstan Olympic team here, which are awesome to train with, and then also a lot of international athletes who are also trying to qualify for the Olympics, so it was really good to do. Every time we switch, we get a good partner, and they're always elite, and lots of feedback unless you get stuck with Mitch, because you're in a bit of trouble from there. The training's been really defined, and you feel like an athlete here. It's like, there's a doctor on hand, masseuse on hand at all times. All the food is provided. There's food for people who are cutting weight, food for people who need protein and carbohydrates, and preparing for each competition, so... because it's back-to-back comps around this period of time, so it's a lot of like refining techniques and just adjusting little things that can help us get through the next comp.
They also have a head strength and conditioning coach that specializes different sessions for I don't know, different exercises that
speed,
his speed and power and all that sort of stuff. So he, I think we worked with him a few times. It's good to actually do some non-kumite sessions in a camp-like environment, because sometimes your brain just gets a bit mushed with all the karate that goes on. So you get really prepared, not only just physically but mentally as well, for comps like Shanghai.
It's if we make it to Shanghai.
That's if we make it to Shanghai. So the visa we were actually supposed to get turned out to be a bit of a mission impossible. We were applying from Kazakhstan, so we had to kind of change a plan of attack and book last minute and quite expensive new flights, cancel the old ones and try to refund those. And this was all after we'd been rejected by the Chinese embassy twice. But thankfully now it's all sorted and we got it all worked out. So I've got to say I'm pretty keen.
Hopefully.
We're not there yet.
I've got to say I'm pretty keen for this next Premier League.
Yeah, so provided we do compete, this one, as Mitch said, is a Premier League. Whereas the last one we came back from was an A-Series in Istanbul. So there's a couple of differences. The A-Series is open to as many people as you want, so that's why we get huge divisions of over 200 sometimes. Whereas the Premier League is limited to only 64 players, and they all have to be ranked in the top 100. So it's a much stronger event. The top ones in the world are always there, and it's also worth twice as many points for ranking, so they're kind of also twice as important, but twice as hard to get through the rounds. This one coming up in China is going to be a really strong competition for us, and hopefully with the training and the prep that we've been doing, actually not hopefully, I'm pretty confident.
I think
we're all looking for some good results.
Yeah, pretty well. Yeah.
So after the Premier League in Shanghai, we head back to Kazakhstan, but this time we're going to Astana for the Astana Open. We have a little bit of training, a few days of training with the Kazakhstan team beforehand, and then we're going to jump into the competition and then have a few days training afterwards. And then we head to the Series A in Montreal, which, as Barney mentioned, is an open competition. So we're expecting big events and lots of competitors. So really excited for that. And hopefully the few days training, the back-to-back comps can help us prepare and work towards a good result.
And then finally going home.
Yeah, after Montreal, we go home. So I think we'll be able to squeeze in one more video
before
we go. So I think we've got a few more weeks and then that'll be it. So once again, thanks guys for supporting and catching up. And you guys can follow us on all that sort of Instagram, Facebook, and whatever. So we'll see you guys in the next one. All right, cheers.
Thanks.
Unfortunately, losing third round to France. Why is this funny?
this is really good.
I don't know why I'm funny. It's so funny.
Am I talking too long?
I don't. I've never heard you speak like this before.
You know, I do teach.
Yeah,
I get up there. And it's like,
good job. All right, go. Lost to whatever.
Yes, it's been awesome joining you. I'm so sorry.
I'm so sorry.
I thought that was really good.
That was really good.